This is not a magic trick. This is a little game. This is my favorite game in the whole world. Give me a little glass. A pea. And a little walnut shell. Well, these aren't really walnut shells. They used to be really walnut shells, but I had them cast in silver. I've been very lucky at this game over the years. You look like you got a pair of eyes on you, sir. Let me ask you a question. Where's that little pea gone to?
One would suspect the middle.
You have eyes like a red-tailed hawk. I think I'm going to have to move these shells around to confuse you. What's your name?
My name is Bill.
Bill? You ready?
Yeah.
Because people are never quite prepared for the rapid hand manipulation of the operator.
I suspect so.
I don't want you to come whining to me later that I was moving too fast. Right. You ready? Here we go. Here we go. Whoa, look at that. Oh, nobody can follow this. This is just, whoa, I lost myself.
I got to leave. I can't keep up with that.
They always let you win the first time.
Oh, that's true.
Where is it?
I'm thinking the right side. My right.
That's a good guess, but that's wrong.
See,
that first time in the middle, that was your first time. This is the second one. I'll give you a third chance. I would go here if I was you.
No, I'm going far left.
I would go here if I was you.
I'm still going far left.
You should listen to me. I actually know what to say. Let's try it again. Here. Maisie, you keep up with this.
Okay. Maisie, help me out.
You ready? You ready?
All
right,
here it is.
Okay, you ready? Uh-huh. Now I'm gonna give you some help. Because he can fend for himself. I don't want you to feel silly. So here's what's gonna happen. I'm gonna show you. If you watch between the shells here, Maisie, you're gonna get a glimpse of the pea moving from one shell to another. The pea does not stay under the shell it starts from. That's why you lose. What you want to do is watch between the shells like that. Okay. Between the shells, you'll see a little glimpse of it. Now that's half speed. I'm going to do it once at half speed, then I'll do it once at full speed so you can compare the two.
Okay.
You ready?
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Whoa.
I thought that was my next guess, but of course.
That was a full speed one. Full speed.
We need a half speed.
I'll tell you what, maybe I should tell you a bit about the history of this game because it's very old. This game is so old, in fact, we don't even know the name of the person that invented it. It may have been a man, it may have been a woman. We don't even know. But I'm going to call him Throg. Throg was evidently a Neanderthal fella, had half a coconut shell and his little river pebble he was playing with, his favorite pebble. He covered that pebble by accident one day, and to his primitive brain, it was as if the pebble just disappeared into thin air. He looked all over. He couldn't find it by accident. He lifted it up. There it was. This was like a 2001 moment for this guy. This kept him occupied all afternoon. He took it back to the campfire and showed it to the other Neanderthals. It became the most popular game of the Neanderthal period, called the one-shell game. Kept him busy all day. That was the one-shell game. What?
It's still there.
Yeah, of course. But eventually, as man's cranial capacity grew, the game lost a bit of its cachet. Till some brilliant Cro-Magnon man, some genius Cro-Magnon man, came up with the idea of adding two more shells, just thus creating what we call the three-shell game. Now, they didn't do it the way we would do it. They would just move these two extra shells around to confuse everybody. This was before logic had been invented by the Greeks. Before logic was invented by the Greeks, they always bet on these two because they were the ones that were moving. Before logic was invented, that would have wouldn't make sense to a modern audience. It's amazing. Well, Tim, you haven't done a damn thing. Let me.
Tim's been slacking.
Yeah, you've been slacking. Yeah. Tim, just. take any shell and put it on top of the pea. Just put it right on top of the pea. That's good. Put the glass on top of that. Excellent. Ooh. Hold your finger out like this. Excellent. You get to pick one of those. Put your finger on top of that. Don't let me cheat. This is between you and me. Now look at this. If you were on the street, this would be a very strong position to be in. Because you know what? You know where the pea is. You know you have control of two of the shells. There's no way I can cheat. At this point on the street, you would put every dollar in your purse down on this table, would you not? That would be a mistake there.
Wow.
Check.
Oh,
wow. Check, Tim. Okay. See, that's a shell game.